Hello students, welcome back to effortless chemistry. Already we have started the group 17 of the p block elements, and the last class we have discussed up to oxidation states. Now we will discuss oxidizing property of halogens. So already we know what is oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So just we will go for a glimpse of that one. Whenever atom loses or gains electron, atom is having two possibility to achieve the octet configuration. Already we know that one. So whenever atom loses electron, it will undergo what? Oxidation. It undergo oxidation and it acts as a reducing agent. So here whenever it loses an electron, there is a formation of what? Cation. Okay. And another possibility is what? Whenever an atom gains an electron, gaining of electron is what? Reduction. So it undergo reduction and it acts as what? Oxidizing agent. Whenever it gains an electron, there is a formation of anion. So this the tendency of the atom to lose or gain electron, that is expressed in terms of electrode potential value, because so the oxidizing property and reducing property depends on what? Gaining or losing of the electrons. So here the tendency of atom, to lose or gain electron depends on, or it is expressed, gain electron, it is expressed in terms of electrode potential value, So in short, I will write electrode potential value as EP. Okay, there are two types of electrode potential values. I'll write. One is a standard reduction potential value. I will call it as SRP. And another is standard oxidation potential value. There are two types of electrode potential values: standard reduction potential value, standard oxidation potential value. So according to IUPAC, in order to avoid the confusion, we are not using standard oxidation potential values. So whatever the electrode potential values are given, those are directly taken as standard reduction potential values. And here, this standard reduction potential value, again there are two possibilities. It may be positive or it may be negative. There are two possibilities. SRP value may be positive or may be negative. If SRP value is positive, readily undergo reduction, the species that readily undergo reduction, and that species acts as oxidizing agent. If SRP value is positive, the species readily undergo reduction and acts as oxidizing agent. If SRP value is negative and that species undergo oxidation and it acts as reducing agent. So with the help of SRP value, we can identify whether the given species is oxidizing agent or reducing agent. Only you have to concentrate on the values of SRP. If it is a more positive, readily undergo reduction, acts as strong oxidizing agent. If it is a negative, undergo oxidation, acts as strong reducing agent here. So now we'll discuss, that is what, oxidizing property of halogen. For all the halogens, SRP value is positive. For all the halogens, that standard reduction potential value is positive means all the halogens, they will readily undergo reduction by accepting an electron, and they act as what? Strong oxidizing agent. And then that oxidizing property decreases from fluorine to the iodine, because from fluorine to the iodine, this SRP value that go on decreases here. We will write those values here. Next point I'll write. So I hope this is clear for you people. What is oxidizing property? So we know that now that oxidizing property depends on SRP value. So here for halogens, SRP values are positive, and hence they act as very good oxidizing agent here. Suppose if I write fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, all these are having positive value of SRP. I will write SRP value here. So already we know that if SRP value is positive, they are a very good oxidizing agent. For fluorine it is plus 2.87, for chlorine it is plus 1.36 it is, for bromine it is plus 1.09, for iodine it is plus 0.54. So all these are having a positive value of SRP means they are very good oxidizing agent. They readily undergo reduction, they will readily accept an electron here. And the next point is, this positive value go on decreases from fluorine to the iodine. Hence that oxidizing property decreases from what? Fluorine to iodine. Fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent among the halogens. Oxidizing property decreases down the group. From fluorine to iodine. So this is what the concept of oxidizing property. In this one, there is a question, even though the electron gain enthalpy of the chlorine is more than that of the fluorine, why fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent? Since the chlorine is having maximum electron gain enthalpy, it has a maximum tendency to gain the electron, so that it must act as oxidizing agent, that is a strong oxidizing agent. But in this one, fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent. The reason for this one is the SRP value of fluorine is much higher than that of chlorine. Okay, because in this one the electron affinity value will not decide the oxidizing property. That electron oxidizing property that is depending only on what? SRP value here. So for fluorine, SRP value is maximum, hence its oxidizing property is maximum here. Okay, and this SRP value, it depends on three factor, that is bond energy and electron affinity and that hydration energy here. So I will discuss that one. I'll write that question. Even though electron affinity of chlorine is more than that of fluorine, why is the question mark? Okay, so I will discuss that one. The reason for that one is what? Because SRP value of the fluorine is much higher than that of the chlorine, hence fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent among the halogens. And that SRP value that depends on the three factors, that is bond energy, electron affinity as well as hydration enthalpy. So one point you make it clear, only electron affinity will not decide the oxidizing property of the halogen. Oxidizing property of the halogen depends on SRP value, which depends on the three factor, that is the bond energy, electron affinity as well as hydration enthalpy here. So your answer will be what here? Because SRP value, that is the standard reduction potential value of fluorine, that is what in bracket you will write 2.87, is much higher than that of chlorine. For chlorine it is 1.36. Hence fluorine acts as strong oxidizing agent. Next line will write SRP value depends on three factors. Always you keep in mind the oxidizing property of these halogens in the aqueous medium, that is decided on the basis of SRP value, not on the basis of electron affinity value. Okay, this SRP value, it is a combination of bond energy, electron affinity as well as hydration enthalpy. Those three factors makes the SRP value of fluorine more positive than that of chlorine. So this is because of what? Fluorine, it is acting as what? Strongest oxidizing agent here. So that depends on what? Three factors. First one I will write, that is a bond energy. Okay, the second one is electron affinity, and the third one is hydration energy. Hydration enthalpy it is. Now for fluorine and chlorine we will write these three factors. For fluorine molecule, that bond energy of fluorine molecule is less than that of chlorine. Already we have discussed this one, because of high interelectronic repulsion among the non-bonding electrons of the fluorine, its bond energy is less than that of what? Chlorine. Next, electron affinity of fluorine is less than the chlorine. Next, hydration enthalpy. Hydration enthalpy of fluorine is more than that of the chlorine. Okay. So, for SRP value to be positive, if SRP value has to be positive, then bond energy must be less, electron affinity must be more, and hydration enthalpy must be higher here. So here bond energy is less and hydration enthalpy is also more. Because of these two factors, SRP value of the fluorine, it becomes more positive as compared to the chlorine. Only electron affinity will not decide the SRP value. The combination of these three will give what? SRP value here. So that's why what happens here, the SRP value of fluorine is more than that of what? Chlorine. Hence it is a strongest oxidizing agent. This is a oxidizing property which is based on the SRP value. Now we'll go for the reactions. In this one, first point, usually a halogen atom oxidizes halide ion of higher atomic number. So already we know that this fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent, than the chlorine, than bromine, and then the iodine. So this fluorine, it takes electron from the chlorine, it takes electron from the bromine, and it takes electron from the iodine, so that it oxidizes that chlorine, bromine as well as iodine. Oxidizing property of chlorine is more than bromine and iodine, so that this chlorine takes electron from bromine as well as from the iodine. And oxidizing property of this bromine is more than that of iodine. This bromine can easily take electron from the iodine here. That is what the usually a halogen atom can oxidize halide ion of the higher atomic number here. For example, if I take here, we'll write the reaction, that is 2 times of Cl minus, this on treating with F2. These two electrons are taken by fluorine, it forms what? 2F minus plus Cl2, so that this chlorine is oxidized by the fluorine. Next you can take chlorine and bromine also. So 2 times of Br minus, this on treating with chlorine, chlorine takes electron from the bromine, so that this is minus one oxidation state. It is oxidized to the zero. It forms two times of Cl minus plus Br2. Next, you can take two times of iodide. This on treating with bromine, so that bromine can take electron from the iodine. It forms what here? That is two times of Br minus plus I2. This fluorine, it oxidizes water to the oxygen. Suppose if I write water molecule, this on treating with fluorine, take 2 moles of water molecule and I will write 2 moles of fluorine molecule. It will form what? This fluorine combines with hydrogen to form 4 times of HF plus oxygen is coming outside. You can see here oxygen, that water is oxidized to what? Oxygen. Oxygen is minus 2 and here it is 0. It is get oxidized here. Next, in the acidic medium, iodide ion is oxidized by the oxygen. 4 times of I minus, 4 times of H plus, plus you can write 2 times, that is a 1 mole of oxygen. These 4 hydrogen combined with 2 oxygen to form 2 moles of water plus, and this will be coming out as 2 times of iodine, because this iodide is oxidized to the iodine, where minus 1 oxidation state become as what? 0 here. They get oxidized. So this is what the oxidizing property here. The next thing, this chlorine and bromine, they will react with water. This chlorine reacts with water, and even you can take bromine also reacts with water to form, that is hydrohalic and hypohalous acid. You can write like this. You split the molecule, water molecule, like this. So what you will get here? HCl plus HOCl, HCl plus HOCl. Next, this is HBr plus HOBr. This is HOBr. These are called as hypohalous acid. That is hypochlorous acid, hypobromous acid. And this is hydrogen chloride and this is what? Hydrogen bromide. So they will form hydrohalic acid as well as hypohalous acid. Whenever they are dissolved in water, only chlorine and bromine, they will form this type of acids. Whenever fluorine is treated with water, it oxidizes water to the oxygen. Okay, this is what the oxidizing property of these halogens. Next point. So the next point is reactivity towards hydrogen. Reactivity towards hydrogen. So these halogens, they will react with hydrogen to form hydrogen halides. H2 reacts with X2 and halogen is minus 1, hydrogen is plus 1. They will form HX type of hydrogen halides. I will take 2 times of hydrogen halides here. So this also gas, this also gas, and this also gas we will take. Okay. And these HX hydrogen halides, in the gaseous medium, these are called as what? Hydrogen halides. Because in gaseous medium, these are not acidic in nature. They will give proton only when they are dissolved in water. In the aqueous medium only, they will give proton. Hence, they are acidic only in the aqueous medium. So, in the gaseous medium, simply we call it as hydrogen halide. Suppose, if I take it in the aqueous medium, HX in the aqueous medium, we'll call it as hydrohalic acid. Then we call it as acid. Hydrohalic acid. For example, if I take HCl gas, so it is called as hydrogen chloride. Hydrogen chloride. Suppose if it is taken in the aqueous medium, HCl in the aqueous medium, then it is called as hydrochloric acid. Okay. So you keep in mind, in the aqueous medium only, they are acidic in nature. Then we will write the different types of halides, that is HF, HCl, HBr and HI. These are the type of the halides that are formed by reacting with hydrogen. Here hydrogen, halogen, both are same size. Hydrogen, chlorine size increases. Hydrogen as it is, again bromine size increases. Hydrogen as it is, again iodine size increases. Down the group, the size of the halogen atom increases, hence their ability to form the stable bond with the hydrogen decreases, because what happens here, down the group, bond length go on increases with increasing the size of the atom like this. HBr is having longer bond length and still HI is having longer bond length like this. So down the group, what happens, with increasing the size of the halogen atom, bond length is increasing, bond length increases, reactivity increases because bond energy decreases here. So among these halides, HI is the least stable halide and HF is what, more stable halide. So if I write the order of stability of halides, HF is more stable than HCl, than HBr, than HI here. So this HF is more stable, most stable hydrogen halide, and this is the least stable hydrogen halide here. This is what the order of thermal stability. So we can call it as this thermal stability decreases down the group with increase in the bond length here. So bond energy increases, stability increases. Bond length increases, stability decreases here. Already we know that stability inversely proportional to the reactivity. Next point, the acidic nature and the reducing nature of these hydrogen halides increases down the group, because down the group again that bond length is increasing, means so this longer bond length can be easily broken, reactivity increases, hydrogen as well as the proton, they are coming outside easily. So down the group, their ability or their tendency to donate hydrogen atom increases, reducing property increases. And here in case of HI, this bond can be easily broken, means proton can be easily coming outside. So what happens, acidic nature as well as reducing nature increases down the group with increase in the bond length and decrease in the bond energy. So we can write acidic nature as well as reducing property, both of them, they are directly proportional to the bond length. Bond length increases, reducing property as well as acidic nature increases, and bond energy increases, these two properties decreases. One point you keep in mind here, HF will not show any reducing property. Okay, so we'll write the order here, reducing property as well as acidic nature increases down the group, HF, HCl, HBr and HI. One thing you keep in mind, this one, this will not show what, reducing property, will not show reducing property. So in this one, all of them, they will show reducing property, but this HF will not show reducing property. And another point you can see here, due to the small size and high electronegativity of the fluorine atom, this HF molecule is involved in the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Because of that, due to presence of the hydrogen bonding, this HF is liquid, but the remaining hydrogen halides, these all are gases because they are not able to form hydrogen bonding. In the remaining hydrogen halides, only weak van der Waals force of attraction is present, but in case of HF, the stronger hydrogen bonding is present, hence its physical state is what, it is available in the liquid state and remaining all are gases here. Next we will point out the boiling point here. So the same thing can be written for the boiling point also. Suppose If I want to discuss the boiling point, this is HF, HCl, HBr and HI. Already we know that down the group the molecular size go on increases, because size of the halogen atom increases, molecular size increases. As the molecular size increases, that weak van der Waals force of attraction that increases here. So due to increase in the size of the molecule, van der Waals, I'll write in short, this is van der Waals force increases down the group, hence boiling point increases down the group here. So from HCl to HBr, HBr to HI, that boiling point increases. But if you go for the boiling point of HF, here the HF, the boiling point of HF is more than that of the remaining halides, that hydrogen halides here, because this HF is involved in the hydrogen bonding. Because of small size and high electronegativity of the fluorine atom, it is involved in the hydrogen bonding. So its boiling point is higher than that of the remaining hydrogen halides here. In this case, only what happens? Weak van der Waals force of attraction is present. So down the group, their boiling point increases. But the boiling point of HF is higher than that of the remaining hydrogen halides, that is due to the presence of hydrogen bonding. These are not able to form hydrogen bonding. Due to the presence of hydrogen bonding in the HF, again it is what? Available in the liquid form, and the remaining hydrogen halides, all of them are what? Gases. So this is about the reactivity towards the hydrogen. Next point, reactivity towards oxygen. Reactivity towards oxygen. Towards oxygen. Always you keep in mind, this halogen, it combines with the oxygen to form a number of oxides, but most of them are unstable. Most of the oxides which are formed by the halogen atoms, they are unstable. So the first point, halogen forms number of oxides with oxygen, but most of them are unstable. Most of them are unstable. The stability of oxides is in the order of 10^-3 more than chlorine, more than bromine. So this is the order of stability of the oxides. Next important point is, always oxides of higher oxidation state are stable here. Okay, and another point is, so these halogens, they will form oxides with the oxygen, except fluorine. Remaining halogen, chlorine, bromine and iodine, they are less electronegative than the oxygen. That's why their oxides are called as what? They are compound with oxygen, they are called as oxides here. But the binary compound of fluorine with the oxygen, they are called as fluorides, because fluorine is more electronegative than the oxygen here. First point, oxides of fluorine, that is a binary compound of oxygen with fluorine, is called fluoride. The reason for this one is fluorine is more electronegative than oxygen. That's why they are called as what? Fluorides. With the oxygen, this fluorine, it forms two compounds, that is fluorine plus oxygen. Two compounds are formed. One is dioxygen difluoride, another is oxygen difluoride, and these two are very good fluorinating agents. Very good fluorinating agents. But at the room temperature, only OF2 is stable. O2F2 is not stable at the room temperature. Only OF2 is stable at room temperature. So this is we'll write the structure of O2F2. This is isostructural with H2O2 it is. So the structure we can write in this one, oxygen shows plus one oxidation state. It is like this: fluorine, oxygen and fluorine. Already in the periodic table we know that the oxidation state of fluorine is always it is -1. To balance this -1, this will be +1. To balance this negative charge, again this will be +1. This is a dioxygen difluoride. Dioxygen difluoride it is. Next, OF2 we will write. OF2 is oxygen difluoride it is. In that one, oxygen shows +2 oxidation state. If I write OF2, it is oxygen difluoride. In this one, I'll write fluorine. Two fluorines are there, which are connected to one oxygen. This is also -1. This also -1. Total two negative charge. So that oxygen shows +2 oxidation state only with the fluorine, because fluorine is more electronegative here. As already we have discussed that these two are very good fluorinating agents. This OF2 or O2F2, it will oxidize plutonium to the plutonium hexafluoride. That plutonium is oxidized to plutonium hexafluoride. That is, this on reaction with O2F2 will take 3 times. Total 6 fluorines are there. You will form PuF6 plus 3 times of O2. So this reaction is used to remove the plutonium from the spent nuclear fuel here. This reaction is used to remove plutonium from spent nuclear fuel. Okay, this is about fluorides, which forms with oxygen. Next, remaining elements, they will form oxides because they are less electronegative than the oxygen. Hence, their binary compound are called as what? Oxides. Only in case of fluorine with the oxygen, they are called as fluoride, because fluorine is more electronegative here. Now, we'll discuss the oxides of chlorine. It will form different oxides, that is Cl2O, ClO2, ClO3, Cl2O7. Oxidation state of chlorine +1, +4, +6, and +7 it is. So in this one, the ClO2 is very important. It is used as bleaching agent. pulp paper and textile and in water treatment. And all of these oxides, they are very good oxidizing agents because they will readily undergo reduction, so that all are very good oxidizing agents here. Next, bromine. One thing you keep in mind, almost all oxides of these group 17, they are unstable. Bromine, it forms Br2O, BrO2, BrO3, oxidation state plus 1, plus 4, and plus 6 here. Again, these are stable only at low temperature and are very good oxidizing agents here. Next, in case of iodine, it forms I2O4, I2O5, and I2O7. So the oxidation state will be plus 4. This can also be written as IO2. And here it is, oxidation state is plus 5, and this will be plus 7 here. Out of this, again, these all are very good oxidizing agents. And this I2O5 is very, very important. This is used in quantitative estimation of carbon monoxide.